everyone. This is Alex of Pacific Northwest Bible Journaling. And as you can see, I was so excited to dive in. I just started right in with the paint. This process video covers the newest October kit by Creative Retreat. The content is written by Aaron Davis, and I adore the fall color scheme. I am a fall girl through and through. It's my favorite season. I love every time of year for different reasons, but honestly, I think fall is my favorite. So when I saw these deep, rich colors, I was so excited. However, I don't own a lot in these colors. And so you'll see here, I am mixing up some acrylic paints. I think they're primarily Apple Barrel, but they're just a collection of things I had. Both the green and the kind of burgundy color, I had to add other colors to get the color I want. This devotional, God Can, is an absolutely beautiful compilation of stories that focuses in on Esther, but I love that Aaron talked also about Moses and the disciples. She really provided a range of scripture references that you can dive into with this idea of what, even when you can't, or you feel overwhelmed, or life is too much, or the call is too big, God can do it. And on the pre-printables this month, it has the phrase God can. It also has the phrase God did. And I love that, that he has done it already, and that he still can do it. And so I chose to dive into the passage in Exodus chapter 6, verses 10 and 11. You'll see I scraped the paint on here and I had darkened and changed the color to match kind of the plum color of the kit next to Exodus 6, 9, and 10, where Moses is discussing, God is calling Moses to stand up against Pharaoh. One thing you'll notice with the creative side of this here is I did not like the green. I went, ooh, that's like an evergreen, not a deep forest green that I want. And so I added some black to it and I re-scraped. I was much more pleased with this slightly deeper green, kind of hunter green that I got when I mixed in some black. So that was a save on the part of the acrylic paint mixing. But anyways, I was really taken aback and reminded that Moses was just this guy with a stutter, and he was called to go up against this powerful man. And it resonated with me because I feel like there are certain things in my life that either the call feels too big, or the cause feels too big, or it feels like something other people have already tried to tackle, and why would you give me this calling, or nobody understands. There's just so many parts of calling that feel intimidating. And looking at Moses and how he didn't let that ultimately stop him. He questioned God, he wasn't sure, but he didn't let it stop him. And so here, I did the scraping with a card that was just an art card, but you can use any kind of like used gift card or insurance card or whatever to scrape that base layer. Then I used the brushes to add some additional vertical skinny lines, also to draw your attention to the verses of 9 and 10. And I had kind of pre-scoped out that I wanted to use these white circle stickers that came with the kit. The letters are of the variation of the different kit colors. So kind of the plum, the mustard, the hunter, and the kind of a navy color. So I knew I needed a backdrop that the white would stand out. And then here I took one of the alphas, I think it's an X, and I put a heart over it because I realized the navy colored heart that I wanted to use, because I didn't have navy paint, wasn't going to stand out enough. So I used one of the letters that I am less likely to use as a backdrop for the heart. So this is my heart created for this purpose. And I wanted to remind myself that even when other people have already tried to tackle it, or even when it feels too big, my heart is created for these things, much like we hear with Esther, for such a time as this. And I don't know the impact, maybe, but that my heart was created for this calling that he gave me. And so here I am. I've got the basics, the words down. I'm going to do a little white splatter to kind of make, to bring a little vibrancy to this paint section. And I got a little stumped because while the stickers were white, I didn't want to write my journaling in white. And so then I was like, okay, I got to take a break. And I decided to do my tab cluster at the top. I love this mustard color that is the reflection questions. The back is actually more of the navy with the crown. And since I wasn't focused on Esther, I didn't use the crown image, but I wanted to use this mustard color. So I put the blue, navy part toward the back and used the mustard to stand out, a bit of this beautiful burgundy washi that has gold floral print on it. That's one reason why I put gold on my palette. I didn't end up using it. I kind of wish I had. And then I wanted to bring the colors that were used down below to the top. So I used the foresty evergreen color and the mustard heart. I did like that the heart mustard is slightly different than the tab. I was looking to see if there was a word on the stamp pad that might work on the tab. I didn't feel like any of them were kind of the one I wanted. I really want the word heart because it's my heart created for this, but it wasn't part of the kit. Use a little bit of Illustrated Faith tape there. That one is no longer available. I did link some other Illustrated Faith products with Dayspring below, just simply because I use them and so you know what they are, but also because this, including this ink pad, there is a sale going on over there, and I put a coupon code below if you're interested in shopping that sale. I also put the link to this date stamp, which is Studio Calico Mega Date Stamp. I do love the Creative Retreat kits, but there are certain things that she just doesn't make. So I did link those below. That being said, this kit has everything you need in it to make this entry. You could completely just write the date. You could just use the washi included. So I did use some Word Fetti. I looked for the word heart because I realized I didn't feel like that blue heart. It was clear enough that I was saying my heart is created for this purpose. So I wanted the word heart. I found a second one of the word heart to put at the top on the tab. I really wanted like created heart, but I couldn't find the word created. So either I'm gonna add it with my typewriter later on a sticker, or maybe I'll come across the word and add it at another time. I'm always keeping my eyes out for Word Fetti that fits different things. So I looked and looked and couldn't find the right word. So what I went back to as a problem once this tab was done is, again, I still had this dilemma of there's this beautiful piece of art I've created on the bottom, and I don't know how I'm gonna get my journaling, my thoughts down, because I didn't wanna write in white. And so I have not found a great white pen. If you have one, let me know. So I'm still, you saw my fingers there. Oh, this space it's got me stumped. I did turn to a paper punch at one point. I think you'll see that here. I tried punching out some squares. It really wasn't big enough. So then I tried, if I punch two, what are they going to look like if I punch two? I just did not love how they were going to lay. And I felt like if I used them, I had to glue them on. And I didn't like no matter where I placed them, I kept thinking like you're going to lose a lot of the art, the colorful stuff behind it. And I couldn't place it where you could still see enough of the variety of colors. So in the end, I end up discarding those. What I did do was I decided to jump over onto my typewriter. Because I thought if the paper piece I use, I couldn't find anything that would just work. So I just put some lightweight cardstock or heavy duty paper into my typewriter, and you'll see I typed out my journaling. Once I had my thoughts down, I actually really liked the shape it had. And I really had liked some of the arrow-shaped paper pieces I had found, but they were all too big for the space. So when I actually cut out my journaling that I had done on the typewriter, I realized, I could make it my own little arrow shape. And I also decided if I don't glue it down all the way, I don't lose the art behind it if I make it like a tip-in, a lift flap, like in kids' books. So I use a little bit of the washi provided in the kit and a little bit of the black and white hash washi, art mark washi, to adhere it to the page. And then I also decided I wanted to have it. And with these tip-ins, you just have to keep in mind your washi has to stop just shy of the end. If you put the washi beyond the edge of the paper that you're using, it won't open. So keep it shorter than the actual edge of the paper. And then I said, I want to put something underneath here on this banner that is like a little peekaboo. And what I really came back to was the whole title of this message being God can do it when you feel like you can't, which is what I ended up writing about in my journaling. So I thought I will put God can on this banner, and behind my journaling, you'll find this little secret surprise. So one thing I did do intentionally was I picked of all three or four colors of the alphas, and I tried to spread them out again, to provide a bit of each color. So I'll read you what I wrote. I just said, God, it feels so lonely to stand and obey when others don't seem to understand, or I feel so much smaller than the calling you have laid on my heart. But I am, my heart is, created by you for this purpose, and I want to remember that when I don't think I can, you, my powerful God, can and you will. And then I grabbed a forest green artistry pen and I just highlighted the scriptures where Moses was talking about Pharaoh and his calling, and I was done. And that was a pretty simple entry considering I just used some acrylic paint and the stickers provided in the kit. I hope you enjoyed and you feel inspired. This is Alex of PNW Bible Journaling here with the Creative Retreat YouTube channel. And be sure to check out the description below for a link to grab your own Creative Retreat October kit, God Can, to join in with the Creative Retreat Insider Group, check out the blog, or use the shopping links.